Thanks so much, Jesse. You know, these days we're hearing a lot about extreme weather.
From floods to fires, hurricanes and tornadoes, there's a lot that can impact families, homes and property.
Bonnie Schneider is a national meteorologist who wrote a book on extreme weather and offers some advice about technology at your fingertips that can save you a lot of headaches should the weather suddenly impact you.
Just in the last year, if we look back to 2017, there were actually 16 natural disasters. That's 33% higher than the previous year. And when I wrote my book, Extreme Weather, I also found year to year we were getting more hurricanes or snowstorms and things like that. There's a number of different factors. We have, of course, you know, the warming of the climate. That slight increase in temperature allows more moisture to be in the air. More moisture in the air means, unfortunately, longer flooding events, more supercharged storms. It's a very slight difference, but it can make a big difference. I also found that more people are living in areas that maybe weren't as populated as before, so you might find more people along coastlines, and they're more impacted by extreme weather. Have a family disaster plan in place for your family. Practice it. Know what to do in event of an emergency so you're ready. Have enough food and water per person for 3 days. Make sure your prescriptions are up to date and anything else that you might need. Another thing you can do, of course, is to implement technology that maybe wasn't available years ago, like using your smartphone to take pictures. So you want to take pictures of your property, take pictures inside your home, and of course your documents. This way you're digitizing all of your records. This will come in handy for insurance. If you have to file a claim, you'll have what you need. It'll be one less thing to worry about.
When you are researching in your book and everything, what is one thing or a tip that you can give people that people don't do that they should be doing to prepare for a disaster?
I'm so glad you asked me that, because I spoke to people all over the country, and you know what the one thing that I found that was unanimous? They didn't check the forecast. They went on a camping trip, they went to leave the office early in a snowstorm, and they were caught off guard. So I would say be weather aware, check the forecast, make sure you take it seriously.
Is there a place where viewers that are watching us right now could go that would help them with that sort of checklist to get information? Because as you mentioned, technology is key in this day and age.
Oh, it sure is. If you go to esurance.com/insights, there's information on everything we talked about, plus even more tips about how you could use technology to stay better prepared.